So we're going to reclaim that power. You are the person who's empowered. You can make those decisions. You can have whatever you want whenever you'd like, and you have unconditional permission to eat. Welcome to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Stephanie. I'm Long Island's eating disorder specialist, and I post on this channel all about eating disorders, body image issues, and general mental health. So if any of that interests you, please click the subscribe button down below. I'm going to be talking a little bit more about the Minnie Maud method of eating disorder recovery in this video today. I know that a lot of you are interested in it, and I know that there's a lot of information out there, but at the same time, like, no information out there. I've done a bunch of videos actually on this, and I will leave that playlist in one of the cards. So I would really encourage you to check it out to go more into detail as to what this is. But what I really want to focus on in this video is two main points. So the first main point I want to make is that the whole purpose really of the Minnie Maud method is to let your body get to the point of acknowledging and knowing that it's no longer in a restriction mode. So for instance, let's say you never allow yourself to have cookies. For the Minnie Maud method, you have to allow yourself to have cookies. No food is off the table, unless of course, like, you're allergic or, you know, you're gonna have a severe reaction. We don't want that. But within reason, everything that you can have without getting horribly ill is going to be something that you have to allow yourself to eat, especially the things that you enjoy eating, even if you might consider them bad foods. This is super important in the recovery method, in this particular recovery method. So you need to say, okay, I love cookies. I never really let myself have them. And I know it's really scary to give myself unconditional permission to eat. That's another part of it, to have these cookies. So if I want to have this cookie, I want to have Oreos, and my body just keeps making me have more and more and more, part of it is doing it. And I know that's really, really scary. So even if you had a lot of cookies, a bunch of cookies, even if you had the whole, you know, close to the whole package or whatnot, it's something that this is an important part, is to allow yourself to have it. You're going to have judgments, but the best thing that you can do is really work toward becoming more non-judgmental of yourself and compassionate toward yourself. This is part of the process, and you need to trust the process. The big part of the process is you need to, again, let your body know that you're no longer going to say no to it. You're no longer not allowing foods, because it's kind of like going back to when you were a child. If your parents said, no, don't touch that, all you want to do is touch that thing. So we need to say, okay, you've been saying to your body for so long, no, you can't have cookies. And now you're finally allowed to have cookies. You might go a little buck wild, but it's okay. You'll get sick of it. You will eventually hit your quota and be like, you know what? I know now that I can have cookies whenever I'd like. So I don't have to continue to push myself to not eat it or stop eating it. And that's really what this method is about. So it might seem really scary to you. You might seem to think that, oh, this is just binging. That's not healthy. Or I'm just going to be overeating all the time, and that's not healthy. Again, this really comes back to trusting the process. And again, I did a whole video on that, and I have left that in the cards for you to check that out. But it's so crucial for you to work on accepting and trusting the process. It's part of it. You will get to the point. Ultimately, the goal in the Minnie Maud method is to get to a point where you no longer have to, like, you no longer feel that food has power over you, because you are allowed to have whatever food you want, whenever you want. It's always there if you really want it. You can always access that food if you really want it. But you know what? When you know you have it and you know you can have it whenever you want, it takes the allure away. It takes the forbiddenness away. Therefore, that power is lost over you. Popping in quickly here to remind you that if you haven't yet done so, please subscribe to my email list using the link in the description below. You'll get my free recovery starter kit, and that I feel is going to be very helpful for you, whether you are at the beginning of your recovery journey or you're looking at something to reinvigorate your recovery. And the other main message that I wanted to send out to you with regards to the Minnie Maud method is that it's so important to be really working through the mental side of things. So it's hard to do the Minnie Maud method, because it's really scary and it's doing everything opposite of what your eating disorder is telling you to do. And it could cause you to be really self-critical, very judgmental of yourself, and we don't want that. We want to be able to get to the point where you are okay with what you're doing. And it's going to be hard, absolutely, but this is why it's so important to work on coping, to figure out ways to cope and deal with the anxiety that might come along with it. I would highly encourage you that you are working closely with a therapist throughout this process to help you through all those feelings that are coming up, because there will be a lot of feelings. I can guarantee you that. But this is all normal. Again, it comes back to trusting the process. I know you're probably sick and tired by this point of me saying trusting the process, but it's part of the process. And if you can bring yourself to trust that the Minnie Maud method can work for you, if you trust that if you continue to do it, it might not be in your timeline where everything should work out for you, but it will get to that point. The ultimate goal is that you're going to be in control. You are truly going to be in control. Even if your eating disorder is all about control, you controlling your food means you have no control at all. Food has the control over you. So we're going to reclaim that power. You are the person who's empowered. You can make those decisions. You can have whatever you want, whenever you'd like, and you have unconditional permission to eat. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments down below if you are open to trying the Minnie Maud method, or have you ever tried the Minnie Maud method? What are your thoughts on it? You could click my face in the corner of the screen to subscribe to my channel. And I wish you recovery on your journey to finding your state of balance. And I will see you in my next video.